Gradients in SwiftUI can be tricky to use because they often require a deep understanding of how to layer and blend colors effectively while managing SwiftUI's layout and coordinate systems. Creating visually appealing gradients involves balancing color stops, alignment, and even integrating advanced features like animatable gradients. In this video, I'll demystify gradients in SwiftUI, showing you the ins and outs of linear, radial, and angular gradients, as well as practical tips for crafting stunning designs that elevate your iOS apps. Check out the link in the description for my Christmas sale. Today, I'm going to talk about gradients. Now, gradients are such a nice touch. It's not just a simple color, it's a gradient. So let's just dive in. I just created this brand new Excel project. It has just a scroll view so we can see all of those gradients much nicer. So let's just have a rectangle, there we go. And I'm just going to have a frame on it with a height of 100. Okay, so there we have our rectangle, that's fine. Now, how can you add a gradient to any view? First of all, if it's a shape, then you can just give it as a fill, so dot fill, and then just go, not this one, but let's just go dot blue. Okay, now we have it as a blue, and you know, we automatically just added this nice gradient, but we are going to talk about that in just a second. Now it's just filled with a simple color of blue. But there's a subtle gradient that comes with a SwiftUI. If you just add a dot right over here, you can have dot a gradient. And that will just add a little bit of, you know, this is a lighter and this is a darker. It's really nice. This is being used through app icons. This is really, really nice. And, you know, it's just as simple as it gets. Now, if you're not using shapes, then you could just use the foreground style. So let's comment that out and let's do the same with the foreground style and the dot blue dot gradient. I prefer the foreground style because it goes with everything. You choose do you prefer. This Christmas, I'm giving iOS developers the ultimate gift. All my products bundled together for an incredible 91% discount. Included in this offer is the centerpiece SwiftUI Camp, a four-week virtual bootcamp starting January the 2nd, designed to make you an expert SwiftUI developer. The total value of this bundle is $2,280, but you can grab it now for $199. Don't miss this opportunity to develop apps faster and smarter. Get it from the link in the description. Act fast. The sale ends soon. So next up, let's just go ahead and have another rectangle. Okay. And then let's just go with fill again. And now let me just add in a linear gradient. I'm going to have this in a new line so you can see it better. And also let's just add the frame beforehand so we can see it a little bit better. Great. So now I'm going to add a linear gradient and we are going to use the one with the gradient, start point and end point. So let's just go through what that is. So let's go for the gradient. We are going to add in our gradient colors. It's an array of colors. So let's just go with maybe dot white, and then blue, and let's just add black also. Okay, so those will be the colors that the gradient will go through. And then you can just add your start point. Let's just go with maybe just top, and then the endpoint dot bottom. And let's see how that looks like. So you can see that there's white, and then there's blue, and then there is this black. Of course, you may choose to have a different start point and end point. Go ahead and experiment with this. It's really, really nice. And it's really, really simple. You may add two colors for your gradient or three or even more, how many you'd like. And then you just decide, okay, this is the start point and this is the end point. Then there is another gradient. Let's just have another rectangle. Okay, let's add the frame in and then the fill. Dot fill. Closing parentheses. There we go. Come on. There we go. So there's also an angular gradient. So angular gradient. So let's just use the one with the gradient and center. Of course, you may choose any of those initializers, but this is the most obvious one. So for the gradient, let me just have a little bit more than just three colors. Let's just have a gradient colors. And then let's just have maybe dot red, and then dot green, blue, whatever. Let's see how AI completes all of this. Not blue, but let's just have maybe purple, and then yellow will be just fine. And then let's just go back to red again. Orange, that's fine also, dot red. Okay, and then the center will be bottom leading, all of that stuff. You just choose whatever you'd like. And then we are just going to use the circle. As you can see, now we have this angular gradient. Of course, you might not want to use this on a rectangle. It's your choice, but I believe it looks fine on an actual circle. So I made the height a little bit bigger, and let's just replace this to a circle. There we go. It looks much, much nicer. Okay, so you can also set the start angle. Let me just copy this out and paste it in. So let's add our start angle. Let's just go with 0. And then the end angle. And of course, again, you can just use degrees, radians. Let's see what happens if I add in 180. As you can see, just using 180 degrees. In our case, I'm just going to use 360. Let's just see, it's all around. Really nice. And that's how easy it is to add some gradients to your SwiftUI application. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out my Christmas sale. The link is down in the description.